This is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com and my neighbor's dog that's really loud today. In any case, what today's episode is about is one of my favorite tubers that you can eat raw. It's called Sunchokes or Jerusalem artichokes. You can see I grew some in pots, and here's a pot right here. I think this is like maybe a 5-gallon pot. And what happens is they only grow in the summer season. And you can see here's what's left of the stalks. This is in the sunflower family. It makes these tall plants. I mean, these guys, here's one up here. It probably grew at least 6 foot tall. Some of the ones that I had in beds were maybe 12 feet tall. After, the warm season and the cool season happens, the tubers stay alive underneath the ground. And actually, that's going to be a very important topic. We'll talk about it in a little bit. But this grows as a sunflower. It makes these nice leaves and small little flowers that have an incredible scent to them, but they don't taste so good if you try to eat them. I really like their Jerusalem artichokes because the tubers are edible and they're very high in inulin, which is basically a prebiotic. They're sweet to us, but they feed our beneficial bacteria. What we're gonna do today is I'm gonna show you guys, you know, how I grew some sunchokes in a pot, and I also grow them in the ground. Of course, in the ground, if you do grow them, they can be very invasive and actually take over. But in my opinion, an invasive food crop is a good crop to have. So if you do plant them in a raised bed, be prepared that, you know, you won't be able to get rid of them. So, you know that you want to plant them there. But also know this, that they can be a great companion plant. So you could grow these at the beginning of the season, have these grow really tall, and something like runner beans or beans will just vine up the plant very nicely. Actually, I'd done that earlier this year. In any case, today's episode is showing you, if you do plant them in a pot like I did, what happens? And here's actually an extreme example, and I actually have a couple. Here's another example over here. I have all these pots literally that are getting busted out. I mean, these sunchokes expanded so much, it expanded the pot and it literally busted the pot out. You can see this just like it's forming into the shape of their Jerusalem artichokes. That is the power of this tuber. So not only are they powerful underground, they probably won't raise your sidewalk, but they actually did raise my brickwork that was just laid down without any mortar. But these are very powerful tubers, and they're very good because they're a crop that you could grow in the summer and leave them under the ground in the winter and dig them up as you need them so that you can eat some of your homegrown food in the winter time. I mean, that's how nature does it. These would naturally kind of go dormant during the winter, and then in the spring they start shooting up new growth and do it all over and keep multiplying and making more tubers for you to eat. Check my past video where I think I had two plants and it produced 25 pounds of food from just two plants. So these plants can yield an incredible amount of tubers for just, you know, two plants. What I'm gonna do today is I'm gonna harvest all the tubers out of this pot, and this was about a 3-gallon nursery pot, which is what it's called, and we're gonna see how many Jerusalem artichokes you can grow in a 3-gallon nursery pot. So let me see, I got a nice cutter here. I'm gonna go ahead and just rip this, rip that open because the pot's not good anymore anyways. And we're gonna go ahead and rinse these guys off. Now I like to get a big kind of milk crate thing. I think some kind of produce came in here. We're just gonna basically open this pot up into the thing and rip this off. And I mean, look, this whole thing is filled up with all these delicious Jerusalem artichoke tubers. Look at that. And there's the pot that's no longer good because I grew Jerusalem artichokes in there. But look at this. I mean, this thing is loaded. I mean, there's hardly any space for the dirt because there's so many tubers in here. Now, when you find the tubers, I mean, the best eaten tubers are the large ones. The large ones are the ones I like to eat because they're very easy. And you know, once you get a nice nylon bristle scrub brush, you can easily scrub off all the dirt. I like to do the preliminary wash off outside, which I'll do right in the back there so you'll see it. But the big tubers are easy to eat, and how I like to eat these the most is just scrub them off. There's no need to cook these guys, although you can cook them. And I just like to slice them into chips and dip them into a guacamole. They're so delicious. I have a friend that actually air cooks these in her air cooker, like a turbo oven. And you know, she cuts them into French fries, and they're so delicious that way also. Of course, these can be just cooked like normal, like a potato, you know, as a starchy root type vegetable. Let's see, so these are the big ones and the small ones. Now, while you can eat the small ones, The small ones, in my opinion, are much more valuable to use as seed. So you want to plant these seeds to grow more Jerusalem artichokes. After I get all these washed off, I'll share with you that I'm actually going to be selling my Jerusalem artichokes and selling you a nice large bag of them for one low price at the end of this video. So stay tuned to learn how to do that. In any case, let's go ahead and wash these guys off, weigh it up, and share with you how much yield I got out of one pot. Here is actually a Jerusalem artichoke stock plant that we didn't actually harvest. This is actually where I harvested the 25 pounds maybe last year, the year before, that I have a video on, so you can see that. I'm sure there's another 25 pounds in here. So be sure to check my past videos for that episode. I mean, these things get really tall, and you can see some of the dried up flowers. Now, these are propagated once again by the tuber, and what we're gonna do now is basically get all the dirt off the tuber. So I like to once again use this, and I'm just gonna shake out all the dirt, and check it out. All the dirt is now gone, and now I have all the tubers. All the dirt or the compost is now just simply on my compost pile here. Pretty much you don't want to use anything of the roots here. There's nothing left. I just pulled off this tuber here, so this could just all get composted. Once again, there's a small little tuber on here we could pull off, but nothing on the root you really need. All right, so once we got most of the dirt off, once again, all we did, we took this and we just shook it around a little bit. Very simple, very easy. You could also use a wooden framed box with a screen like a hardware cloth. The next step is I like to elevate this off the ground so it doesn't get too dirty. And I'll just take the hose and I'll just spray them down. Move them around, we'll get some of the big leaves and stuff out. All right, take that hose off a little bit more. All right, there you go. That's how easy it is to clean off your Jerusalem artichoke harvest using the right tool, such as a milk crate or a vegetable crate. Next, I'm gonna go ahead and weigh this up and share with you how much yield I got. So I got my Jerusalem artichokes, also called sunchokes, weighed up, and there's a total of about 8.25 pounds in here. So from that small little nursery pot, 8.5 pounds, that's an incredible amount of food for just a small amount of space. As you could see, it was literally busting out the sides and these guys were ready to get eaten. The next thing I wanna show you guys is, real quick, is on these tubers, if you look around, you may see some that are turning a little bit green. Now, those are the ones that you don't want to eat. If they are green, then I would once again use them for seed. Here's a comparison. I mean, this one's nice, white, and pretty. The other thing also is they should be firm. As long as they stay in the dirt, they'll be firm. If you do just like try to harvest all of these and then put them in your fridge for saving, they're gonna go soft on you, so don't do it. Leave them in the ground until you're ready to harvest them. Now, if you do harvest them and then clean them off and you want to get ready for eating, you could save them in something like a 5-gallon bucket. So what I would do then is I would just come over and take some soil and just literally put it in the bucket. Now, you don't want the soil too dry, but you don't want it sopping wet. You want it just a little moist because these guys do need some moisture. So you're just gonna put some soil in the bucket, then you're gonna go ahead and put a whole bunch of the tubers in there, and then guess what? You're just gonna take some more dirt and pile it on the tubers. Then I'll take this bucket, as long as it's nice and covered, and put it in a cool, dry place, such as your garage or shed, so it's gonna stay fresh. And I mean, these guys, I mean, they're meant to stay under the ground, in nature and earth, and stay alive and sprout back in the spring. I've even had these when I forgot to actually use them after I saved them, and they started sprouting in the pot. That being said, if you are ready to plant these guys, what you wanna do is you wanna, once again, take a pot, and I'd fill it up with more dirt and not put them as deep, although you could do that because these guys are not picky at all. But I'd basically bury these guys, I don't know, probably about that much underneath the ground. And they're gonna basically grow and flourish into a nice Jerusalem artichoke plant and provide you with tons of tubers the following fall and winter. That's how to store them. And now the next announcement is that I will be making these available to you guys. So I have like such a harvest of these guys, I'll be able to share these with my viewers. And how I'm gonna do it, as you just saw, because these guys basically are stored well in soil and they like to stay a little bit moist. I'm gonna actually take some of my soil here and scoop it into the flat rate envelope. So you're gonna get some mycorrhizae rich biodynamic Sunova compost in the bag. And then we're gonna take some of the tubers, and I'm probably gonna take mostly the smalls because I could probably fit more of them in there, and just fill the bag up. So we're gonna put in a whole bunch of the small tubers, some more dirt so that they'll stay alive and stay fresh and make the mailing and won't like get all soft and weird on you. And just once again, fill up more and fill up more dirt. And so you're gonna get a nice mixture of, I mean, tubers that are probably gonna sprout in the mail if you don't pick up your packet at the PO box or the post office. But in any case, for one low price, you'll get my compost, but also a lot of tubers. I estimate you'll get maybe around 2.5 pounds of tubers, maybe more, maybe less, because we're just kind of going by the tubers, scooping the dirt in so it's gonna stay fresh. We're then gonna seal it off, put the postage on there, priority mail shipping, which is generally 2 to 3 days in the US. Now, sorry, I can only ship to anywhere in the US, anywhere the post office ships to. That includes Puerto Rico, Hawaii, US Virgin Islands, maybe even Guam, but I can't ship anywhere else outside the US, 50 states, or territories of the United States. So I'm sorry if you guys are international viewers. So what you wanna do is click the link below to go to my Facebook page for Growing Your Greens and check out my Growing Your Greens store. I'll have these posted for as long as I have them available. So what I'm gonna do, as soon as I get a bunch of orders, I'm gonna come out and harvest these fresh, bag them up and ship them, and they'll probably go out like on a Monday or a Tuesday. So hopefully you'll get them by the Friday, and you will get tracking information once your orders are shipped through priority mail, and you could track it wherever it is and find out where it is. Now once you get them, all you're gonna do is you're gonna take them out and, you know, put some of maybe your soil and store them in a bucket if you wanna store them till later to plant them, so you could store them in a cool, dry place. Or if your season's mild like it is here in California, you could actually work your soil. So if your soil's frosted, you know, you should probably keep it in a bucket in your garage in a cool, dry place, a little bit moist but not too moist, until your soil is workable. Once it's workable, plant them underneath the ground. I don't know, I'd probably give them 6 inches, although you could go deeper. Plant them in some rich organic compost, of course, and don't forget the rock dust, and they're gonna flourish in the following spring. Now, I don't know how these are gonna do in other locations, but you know what? These are native to North America, so they probably should do good in most areas in the United States. And don't forget, these guys can be invasive, so you are warned. In any case, hopefully you've enjoyed this episode of learning more about one of my favorite raw tubers that I love to eat, the Sunchoke. Once again, my name is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. We'll see you next time, and keep on growing.